Good morning, I'm Clinton Griffiths, coming to you again from Commodity Classic in Houston, where we're following a developing story here in Texas as the state battles a series of massive wildfires sweeping across the Panhandle. Now, the state's governor issuing a disaster declaration for 60 counties. The main blaze, the Smokehouse Creek Fire, swelling quickly into the second largest wildfire in the state's history, consuming 500,000 acres, spreading at an average rate of 150 football fields every minute, with farms and ranches in its path. Mike Valerio has an update.
In North Texas, frantic video of cattle galloping as fast as they can against a backdrop of black smoke billowing from one of at least five wildfires. The people recording also running for their lives.
It looked like Armageddon. It looked like our town was just being engulfed in black.
Some of the flames have jumped into neighboring Oklahoma. The explosive growth of the fire since Monday led to a brief evacuation of a nuclear weapons facility, a site tasked with assembling and disassembling the nation's nuclear arsenal.
Luckily, because of the heroic efforts of our surrounding community, the fire never did come to the Pantex plant.
Employees returned Wednesday, but many residents from the Texas Panhandle communities of Canadian and Fritch are seeking safety elsewhere.
We all were wondering, what is this? What's going to happen? Are we going to be able to return? Is there going to be anything to return to?
We've had extremely hot, dry days these last couple of days, along with extremely high winds.
Texas A&M Forest Service adds firefighters will try to take advantage of Wednesday's weather, a calmer day with lighter winds and higher humidity. But winds are expected to pick up again on Thursday with stronger gusts up to 30 miles an hour.
We will be returning as soon as we can to go assess damages, hug our friends, hug our families, and be thankful that we are all alive and start rebuilding.
I'm Mike Valerio, reporting for Ag Day.